trade and commerce for which an amount of rupees 2 crore has been sanctioned to the ST Corporation. Honorable members, health for all is one of the priorities of my government. The health indicators of the state are the best in the country. My government has introduced Deen Dayal Swasthya Seva Yojana scheme for providing better and affordable health care facilities to the poor and middle class in order to reduce the financial burden on treatment of diseases. As on date, 2.32 lakh active families have been enrolled under the scheme. Goa is awarded as one of the best performing state in reproductive child health portal by Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. Government of India, Pradhan Mantri Bharatiya Jan Aushadhi Pariyojana scheme has been successfully implemented in the North Goa district. Initially covering 5 hospitals, I am pleased to inform that my government is focused on strengthening the infrastructure and improving the quality of medical facilities provided at Goa Medical College and Hospital. Ayushman Bharat and Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana, the flagship scheme of Honorable Prime Minister of India, were launched in the state. As on date, 20,688 golden records have been created. In all, 11 public hospitals and 13 private hospitals are empaneled under the scheme. I am happy to say that no new microfilaria cases have been detected in 2019. As regards HIV, number of persons detected HIV positive have declined from 1,094 in 2007 to 267 in 2019 due to successful implementation of the various targeted intervention programs. The STEMI Goa project was launched with the aim of reducing cardiac mortality and morbidity. The project includes diagnosis of heart attack in peripheral health. STEMI Goa project was launched with the aim of reducing cardiac mortality and morbidity. The project includes diagnosis of heart attack in peripheral health centers using tele-ECG, thrombolysis, using newer thrombolysis and agents, and prompt referral to Goa Medical College, PCI centers or hub, using cardiac ALS ambulances of 108. Under this project, 768 number of STEMIs were diagnosed and 583 thrombolyzed. Honorable members, Vidya Dhanam Sarvdhana Pradhanam, quality education is the backbone for development of human resource of the country. My government is committed for inclusive and equitable quality education, which is one of the sustainable development goals and promotes lifelong learning opportunity to all sections of the society. In order to achieve this goal, efforts are being made to provide quality infrastructure, innovative tools, enhance learning skills, identifying slow learners, and provide counseling and remedial teaching facilities to them. My government supplies free uniforms, textbooks, and raincoats to the primary class students in the state under midday meals scheme, a flagship scheme. Hot cooked food is supplied to all students studying in class 1 to class 8, benefiting 1.62 lakh students. Task of serving meals is allotted to 103 self-help groups, Mahila Mandals, PTAs. During the year till December 2019, rupees 1,714.5 0.32 lakh has been utilized in order to provide quality education. Various initiatives have been taken. Khushi Tide program, a multi-grade, multi-level program enabled by group learning and technology, has been implemented in 24 government primary schools across the state. Cardipati scheme introduced to create an English environment for classrooms to help children learn the language through a process of discovery about Indian culture and rich experiences has been implemented in 100 government primary schools in the state. Safety of students is the priority of my government. Measures have been taken for implementation of the directives of the Supreme Court Committee on Road Safety with regard to display of carrying capacity both inside and outside the vehicle for ferrying school children. To improve the quality of teaching and put forth a modern pedagogy for the holistic educational experience, 60 smart classrooms and 4 virtual classrooms have been installed in 4 government colleges. This new technology allows the resource persons to deliver lectures to audiences at remote places. Government has selected 30 candidates as Goa scholars, and a total of ₹2.49 crore have been disbursed. My government endeavors to use information technology extensively and work towards providing various benefits of information and communication technology to the masses of Goa. Government has approved the setting up of electronics manufacturing cluster under the electronics manufacturing clusters scheme of the Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology. Government of India in Tuem village, Parnem Taluka, is an area measuring about 5.97 lakh square meters. 14 schemes for the incentives mentioned in the startup policy and 18 schemes under the IT policy, which have also been notified and are being implemented since July 2018. Registration of 17 new startups and incentive amounting to ₹81.84 lakh were approved in the High Powered Committee in 2019. Government has signed a MOU with MSSTPI for establishment of state-of-the-art incubation facility at a land measuring about 14,800 square meters of village Taligao, Tiswadi Taluka, Dona Paula, Goa. Honorable members, my government has successfully implemented flagship scheme Pradhan Mantri Kaushal Vikas Yojana in the state. At present, 10 government ITIs and 5 private training partners are providing training under the scheme in the state. A total of 1459 trainees were enrolled, out of which 932 trained, 586 assessed, and 470 certified and 28 placed in order to provide demand-based job-oriented courses. 3 new job-oriented courses, namely multimedia, animation and special effect, solar technician, digital photography, have been introduced in the academic year 2019-20. In order to educate officials and elected members on village panchayat development plans, awareness training have been conducted during November 2019 at GIPARD, Old Goa, in which 2497 personnel were trained. Under Deen Dayal Infrastructure Development Scheme, 11 projects have been completed through GSIDC and GTDC under Swachh Bharat Mission, Grameen, steps are being taken to motivate and educate communities in making village clean with the theme Nital Ghar, Nital Gaon, Nital Goincho, Rakhnohan. Under Swachh Bharat Mission, urban Goa have been classified as open defecation free by Quality Control of India team, which is the certifying agency notified by Government of India. Under credit linked subsidy scheme of PMAY, U640 applicants have been benefited with subsidy amounted to 10 crore. My government has appointed the permanent authority for Goa real estate regular authority, that is known as RERA, wide notification dated 16th October 2019. Honorable members, Nari Shakti. Priority of my government is to create women empowerment. Each and every Mahila Mandal should become an entrepreneur. Equity and equality is our motto in this regard. Universal Women Helpline is established at Goa Medical College, Bambolim, round the clock to support women affected by violence, both in private and public spaces, including in the family, community, workplaces, etc. Financial assistance is provided to the Mahila Mandals, SHGs, for providing training under various states in order to encourage women to undertake income generating activities and become self-reliant. Around 13,830 activities were carried out and reaching 225,942 beneficiaries under the Poshan Ma 2019. In order to maintain reasonability of the standard of living, financial support is provided to 1,33,240 homemakers till December 2019 under the Grih Aadhaar scheme. In order to come out of the myth that a girl child is a burden to the family, my government has introduced Ladli Lakshmi scheme, benefiting around 65,724 beneficiaries. Mining industry was a major revenue and employment generator for the state. My government has extended all possible support to mining dependents, for which financial assistance of ₹108.4 crore has been sanctioned. Under one-time settlement scheme, an amount of ₹96.64 crore has been disbursed to 4,543 beneficiaries. Under umbrella scheme, financial assistance of ₹170.82 crores has been disbursed to 9,020 beneficiaries. Government has deliberated on the issue with union ministers on several occasions and has submitted 4 representations so far. Government has also suggested possible alternatives for amendment of the Goa, Daman and Diu mining concessions, abolition of Declaration as Mining Lease Act 1987, wherein its implementation is sought to be prospective in nature. In the meanwhile, the state is exploring all the possibilities, lawful options to resume mining operations. The state has also filed review petition before Honorable Supreme Court to review its order dated 7 February 2018. Honorable members, my government is very optimistic in resuming mining operations in Goa during the ensuing season, thereby rejuvenated state's economy and lives of citizens. My government has left no stone unturned to explore all possible ways and means for resumption of mining in Goa. In order to give relief to the people affected by mining closure, my government has exempted motor vehicle engaged in transportation of mineral ore from payment of tax payable under the said act for the period from 1/4/2018 to 31/3/2020 under Udyog Aadhaar Memorandum. Till date, 626 units have been filed registered online with a proposed investment of 2,038.7 crores, an employment potential of 71,091 persons. Goa Investment Promotion Board has granted approval to 179 projects in principle with total investment of ₹13,043.48 crore with employment potential of 28.6%. Honorable members, under Goa Tribal Employment Generation Program scheme, the corporation has financed 16 applicants and sanctioned an amount of ₹142.96 lakh and disbursed ₹28.37 lakh. Since inception of the scheme, the corporation has sanctioned financial assistance to 30 applicants for an amount of ₹238.07 lakh and disbursed ₹195.54 lakh. Under MSME Samadhan delayed payment to micro small enterprises, 58 cases have been reported with an amount of ₹872.26 lakh, out of which 24 cases have been disposed of amounting to ₹261.41 lakh. Under CMRY scheme, loan of ₹1,317.39 lakh have been sanctioned, of which ₹892.16 lakh have been disbursed till November 2019. During the year till November 2019, 94.64% of the loan has been recovered. Various schemes have been implemented in order to ensure orderly growth of cooperative movement in the state. And to strengthen it as self-sustaining instrument of socio-economic development in implementing national priorities and policies, 5,044 cooperative societies have been registered. To protect the interest of cane growers and financial difficulties faced by them, my government has invested ₹7.50 crore in Sanjeevani Sahakari Sakhar Karkhana in the form of share capital during the current year. The total investment of the government by way of share capital contribution to the sugar factory stands at ₹98 crore and ₹10.75 crore by way of medium term loan. Honorable members, my government has laid utmost priority for maintenance of roads, bridges and national highways, and also monitors the execution of various national highway projects sanctioned and fully funded by the Union Government. The two projects, namely Khandepur Bridge costing ₹297 crore and Konkana Bypass with Talpona and Galjibagh Bridges costing ₹2,080.16 crore, have been completed. Construction of two-lane bridge connecting Kharwada and Karanjalem village in Madkai Panchayat is Madkai constituency at a cost of 1,104.04 lakh improvement widening and hot mixing of road from Patra Devi Goa boundary to Sasoli Maharashtra boundary in a length of 16.05 kilometers in the state of Goa, interstate connectivity at a cost of ₹361.96 lakh. Improvement of riding quality of the stretch of state highway number 5 from Ambora to Borim 5400 to CH6690 in Salicet Talukas for an amount of ₹405.237 lakh. Construction of 10 MLD water treatment plant at Mesil Dam Panchayat Shiroda constituency, supplying laying, jointing, testing and commissioning of conveying main of various diameters from water treatment plant and MBR towards Shiroda and Panchavadi village at a cost of ₹5,200 lakh, shifting of water pipeline along National Highway 17B from CH00 kilometer to CH3.7 kilometer at a cost of ₹5,168.7 lakh, and improvement of water supply scheme in Morma Goa constituency phase 1 at a cost of 611.94 lakh, and in Pale town in Sankalim constituency 20 MLD water treatment plant at Ganjam at cost of ₹773.19 lakh have been completed. My government is making efforts to provide facilities to all by optimum utilization of rainwater and groundwater resources. Under Tillari Irrigation Project, out of 11,830 hectare irrigation potential created, 6,663 hectare have been utilized till date. A task force committee and a committee for implementation of water security plans for irrigation, integration and synergizing of various water related activities under Jal Shakti in the state have been constituted. The lift irrigation scheme in Damke in village Panchayat Guleli in Satari Taluka is completed. Honorable members, my government is committed to provide uninterrupted quality power supply to domestic, commercial and industrial units, as well as enhancing the transformation capacity. During the current financial year till date, the transformation capacity has increased by 3.7% and the total consumer base has increased by 1% as compared to previous year. The total sale of electricity has increased by 3% as compared to last year. As on December 2019, 281 kilometers of HT cabling have been carried out throughout the state. Under tribal subplan, works worth ₹48 crores have been taken up for execution during the current financial year. The electricity department has achieved an aggregate and commercial losses of around 12% as against the target of 15% set for the state by the Ministry of Power, as against the national average of 21%. About 1.6 lakh LED street lights fittings have been replaced under phase 1. The services rendered by the fire and emergency service personnel have been remarkable in preventing untoward incidents arising due to fire disasters. During the year 2019 and 20, the fire personnel have attended 8,808 fire and emergency incidents, saving 326 human lives and 4. My government is currently encouraging and motivating artisans and institutions under the Kala Samman scheme, an amount of 502.27 lakh was increased to 2,525 artists. Financial assistance amounting to Rs. 478.15 lakh was released to 352 cultural institutions for organizing various programs. Annual maintenance grants for Rs. 35.64 lakh Goa is well known worldwide as a tourist destination due to its mesmerizing beaches, churches, temples, heritage sites, and most importantly, for its hospitality. Tourism industry is the mainstream of Goan economy. In the year 2018, arrival of domestic tourists increased by 2.70% and foreign tourists increased by 4.87% as compared to 2017. During the first half of the year, January 2019 to August 2018, 37.07 lakh and 4.94 lakh domestic and foreign tourists respectively visited the state. Honorable members, emphasis is laid to create state-of-the-art facilities in the state. As a part Swadesh Darshan program, beautification and upgradation of Mayam Lake, providing footbridge and handicap-friendly access, illumination across the creek near Mandaram Beach, illumination of Kalangut Beach, improvement of infrastructure. Facility competition from neighboring states as well as the overseas destinations in tourism sector. Efforts are being made to introduce new tourism related activities such as Bungee destination at Mayam Lake, which is second in India, and hot air balloon services as a part of adventure tourism in order to provide employment opportunities for unemployed Goan youth. Beach shack policy has been formulated and allotted 257 beach shacks in North Goa and 100 beach shacks in South Goa. My government has launched a new vessel along with supply and installation of oil spill equipment to tackle oil spill in the rivers of Goa. Final report of the environmental impact assessment study for initiating phase two of the desilting of River Sal, the marine environmental impact assessment study in association with the dredging at the mouth of River Galgibag, and the rapid marine environmental impact assessment study of the proposed dredging at the mouth of River Talpona have been submitted by the National Institute of Oceanography, Dona Paula, Goa. Dredging across the sandbars at the mouth of River Chapora has been completed at the cost of rupees 610.08 lakh. Captain of Forts has handled 1,850 metric ton cargo traffic and collected revenue of rupees 477.69 lakh during the current year till December 19. It is my pleasure to bring to the notice of honorable members that Goa has won 9 gold, 10 silver, 27 bronze medals at the National School Games and has also won 77 gold, 50 silver and 66 bronze medals at the zonal level Federation Cup, national and international championship. In view of the heavy rains and release of water from Tillari Dam, flood-like situation was forced the talukas of North Goa district. Necessary rescue and relief measures were undertaken by District Disaster Management Authority for evacuating the affected persons to safer places. Assessment of loss was immediately carried out by joint teams comprising of Talati PWD engineer and Panch members, an amount of rupees 67.88 lakh was distributed as relief to the affected persons. My government has been instrumental in bringing about ban on single-use plastic as well as burning of plastic with the enactment of Goa Non-Biodegradable Garbage Control Amendment Act 2019. My government is keen in climatic change and encourage optimum utilization of alternate energy. As a part of this, government has simplified Goa Solar Policy 2017 and notified the amendments. 3.83 megawatt capacity rooftop installation has been completed. A trial of a small wind and solar hybrid system was successfully carried out. We gather once again to celebrate democracy, a cherished value and culture that have prospered throughout the long history of our nation. Indeed, a culture that guides my government towards Sabka Saath, Sabka Vikas, or Sabka Vishwas, I am confident that together we can make Green Goa to Golden Goa. Lok Samtha Sukhino Bhavantu. Om Asato Ma Sadgamay, Tamso Ma Jyotirgamay, Mrityo Ma Amritgamay. Om Shanti, 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 Jai Hind.
Thank you. Members, I request you to take the seats. Secretary, to read on the governor's address copy.
Sir, I lay a copy of the address by the Honorable Governor on the table of the House.
I adjourn the House for 10 minutes.
ईरान और अमेरिका के बीच कभी भी युद्ध छिड़ सकता है और इसका अंदाजा भारत को भी हो गया है। भारत ने आज ईरान के विदेश मंत्री से बात की है। इस वक्त की सबसे बड़ी खबर यह है कि सऊदी अरब में अमेरिकी दूतावास ने मिसाइल हमले का अलर्ट जारी कर दिया है। वहीं इराक ने अपने यहां तैनात हजारों अमेरिकी सैनिकों को देश छोड़ने का आदेश दे दिया है।
take the decision.
We ratify this bill.
Speaker sir can take the decision
afterwards.
Can a decision
gochay? Yeah.
Jab upar decision gochay ki rehte.
You move the bill.
It is up to him.
Honorable CM, BSC report.
Sir, I rise to present the first report 2020, the Business Advisory Committee.
Now, you may move the motion.
Sir, I move that the House to agree with the first report 2020 of the Business Advisory Committee.
Now, I will put the motion to the vote of the House. Those in favour will say ayes. Those against may say noes. The ayes have it, The motion is carried. Honorable CM, to move the resolution.
Sir, I beg to move the following resolution. That this House agree to ratify the amendments to the Constitution of India by the Constitution and 126 Amendment Bill 2019. Now, therefore, it is hereby resolved as under that this House ratify the amendment of the Constitution of India falling within the purview of the Clause D of the Proviso Clause 2 of the Article 368 proposed to be made by the Constitution 126 Amendment Bill 2019 as passed Parliament.
Any members like to speak?
No, it is introduction. It is for ratification.
Introduction.
The resolution is before the House.
Sir, the bill number 1 of the 20.
Yeah, introduce.
Yes, introduce.
Nobody will speak.
It is for ratification. It is for ratification, not for debate.
Now I put.
For ratification.
Speaker sir, last time also there was one bill which was moved for ratification and some members tried to speak and then we realized that then Chief Minister stood up and said that this bill, what we are doing here is we are ratifying, we are not discussing and we are not making anything in that bill. Chief Minister and clarify, it is for ratification passed in the Parliament.
For ratification, actually.
Do you want to speak in favour of the bill?
You have to take a call.
It's a ratification.
Now I put the resolution to the vote of the House. Those in favour will say aye.
Aye.
Those against say no. Ayes have it. Ayes have it.
Sir,
ratify.
Pass.
Introduction.
Speaker sir.
It is just a renewal.
It is
just a renewal.
Speaker sir, as a party, thodi tari history ya Vidhan Sabha in kalpak jaye.
It is just a renewal. It is just a renewal. Navin Kaina Vitun. Navin Kaina Vitun. It is just a renewal.
Speaker sir, I had brought to your notice that after this bill is passed, you have to allow our motion of adjournment.
I am going for the next item.
Now, I am going for the next item. This was an important bill. We said after this bill.
Next speaker, sir. Ulopak, Entity that Gupta.
It is just a rectification.
No. I am going for this. GST.
Honorable CM.
Speaker, sir.
Honorable CM.
Bill has been ratified unanimously. Speaker sir, Speaker sir,
sir, actually, sir, Speaker cannot behave like this. Minister cannot argue with Speaker.
Speaker sir.
I had requested you that since there was this important bill, we said we are supporting this amendment. We have supported. And now our adjournment motion. Please take up our adjournment motion.
Adjournment motion. Now, Speaker sir.
Introduction consider. CM.
Speaker sir. Adjournment motion.
GST.
On important issue.
GST.
GST. Motion one. That we will take afterwards.
GST.
Adjournment motion.
Let him take first.
Adjournment motion.
Speaker, what agenda? Agenda. The card is sent. The card is sent. Why not? Ulo paaji bhi.
Yeah.
No, sir. I'm so subject to ulo paaji. Who is not doing? Who is tenche bhi tallo kider?
Speaker, sir. Speaker sir, under Rule 68, the United Opposition has moved a adjournment motion. The adjournment motion is on the specific issue of Madhuri. Now, under Rule 71, you can allow this. There are three requirements for an adjournment motion. The first is it should be definite, means the subject should be one. Now, here the issue is of Madhuri, which is more important than mother, according to the Honorable Chief Minister, which is the lifeline of Goa, which everybody knows. Jeeva? Ek minute. Speaker sir, I should not be disturbed. I am on my feet. Speaker sir, I am on my feet.
I am giving my ruling.
Speaker sir. Rule 68 cha under vichalla, 71 ata reference dita. 71 kide sakte tumhi sanga. Speaker sir. 68 cha under vichalla hoy. Speaker sir, ruling kya tha? Madhuri amka avay biksha chod asa adunai sangta ani Madhuri khatir je kide karpak jay ti karpachi amchi tayari asa Speaker sir. What issue
Allah sa tala 68 under roni Speaker sir.
Speaker sir, CM kidak modi ulayda. Aun ulayda magi ulay ni
Speaker sir.
Speaker sir, ek issue aha
tumhi we have discretion
tajer ami move kela.
Your discretion
amka dista ki Goy has been cheated mhanun honorable governor an statement kala ki Goyak photayle mhanun Madhuri che आमका हांगा डिस्कशन जाय आमका कन्सेन्सस जाय आमका खबर आहा की सगळे सगळ्यांचे एकमत आहा की मादय म्हणता ती आमची गोयची जीवनदायिनी आणि ही राखूंक जाय हातून आमका फटोवंक जायना गोयकारांक आणि गोयाक आज फटयला वो कॉन्स्टिट्युशनल हेड ऑफ द स्टेट म्हणता स्पीकर सर वो इश्यू इम्पॉर्टंट आणि वो इश्यू तुझे कॉन्स्टिट्युएन्सीक लागतलो
ओव्हर
नो स्पीकर सर वी वॉन्ट दॅट दिस एडजर्नमेंट मोशन शुड बी टेकन अप
One thing, I am straight away giving my ruling here.
You okay. Can give your ruling, Speaker sir.
No, I am giving the ruling.
Give.
Okay. I have received a notice of the adjustment motion.
That I am the Legislative Affairs Minister, therefore I am making a point of order. Speaker sir, this is a special session called only for certain specific purpose. For ratifying law that has been made by the center, number one. Speaker sir, it is the convention whether in parliament or whether any state, whenever adjournment motion is there, it is raised at the beginning of the session not allowing any business and then it is for speaker to give a ruling. In the instant
case, sir,
in the, one minute, let me finish. I'm on my legs.
Yeah.
Speaker sir, in the instant case, business has already been transacted. One constitutional amendment which was necessary has been ratified. The next one is the GST. If at all,
because, sir,
your purpose
GST
is one minute, Speaker
sir,
when they have clearly agreed, when they first you take the GST the second business, and then you can give your ruling.
I am giving my ruling. I have received a notice of adjournment motion dated 7 January 2020 under Rule 68 of the Rules of the Procedure and Conduct of the Business of the Goa Legislative Assembly from Sri Vijay Sardesai and 9 other members on a matter of urgent public importance as listed below to discuss. The approval stroke NOC given to Karnataka by Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change for taking up so-called drinking water project on River Mahadai. Likelihood of misuse of approval stroke NOC for setting up irrigation project by Karnataka, diversion of west flowing river Mahadai into east flowing river Malaprabha, increase in salinity of rivers in Goa, adverse effects on ecology, agriculture, Khazan lands and drinking water in the state of Goa. Now the crucial test is whether the matter proposed to be raised has arisen suddenly and created an emergency situation of such a character that there is a prima facie case of urgency and the House must therefore leave aside all other business and take up into consideration of this urgent matter. The subject matter of the notice deals with the various issues like NOC given, increasing salinity and its adverse effects on ecology, agriculture, etc. Whereas for an adjournment motion should be on a single specific matter as per rule. The approval stroke NOC given to Karnataka by Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change for taking up so-called drinking water project, Kalsa Bandra project on River Mahadai, the members can raise the issue and discuss the same through various parliamentary devices such as calling attention, 0 hour, private member resolutions and also legislative questions to the session and have sufficient opportunity to focus the attention of the House to the said subject matter during the discussion. Now the motion is on subject matter that is being dealt with by the Minister of Environment, Forest and Climate Change, that is a central government ministry, as the matter pertains to an action taken by the central government and as such the notice should state exactly the responsibility or lack thereof the state government on the subject, which has not been brought out in the notice. A matter is urgent only if it is a very recent occurrence. A matter which has been continuing for quite some time cannot be raised through the adjournment motion. It does not relate to a matter of recent occurrence which has arisen suddenly but is a continuing matter. A matter even of very recent occurrence is not urgent if an opportunity for discussion will arise in the ordinary course of business within a reasonable short time. Hence, I find that this is a special session being called for the central government's amendments. The notice of the adjournment motion is not in order for the above cited reason. I therefore disallow the notice of adjournment motion.
Speaker sir.
GST bill.
Speaker sir,
I move to leave to introduce Bill number 1, 2020 of the Goods and Services Tax Amendment Bill 2020.
Yes, sir. Question is that the leave be granted to introduce the Goa Goods and Service Tax Amendment Bill 2020. Those in favor may say aye. Those in against may say no. The ayes have it. The leave to introduce the bill has been granted. The Chief Minister may now introduce the bill.
I beg to introduce the bill for the Goods and Service Tax 2020.
Honorable Chief Minister, may move the motion for consideration of the bill.
Consideration.
Question is that the bill be taken into consideration. Those in favor may say ayes. Those against may say noes. The ayes have it. The motion for consideration of the bill is adopted. Now we will take up the consideration of the bill clause by clause. The question is that the clause 2 to 21, clause 1, the electric formula and the non-writer to stand part of the bill. Those in favor may say ayes. Those against may say noes. The ayes have it. The clause 2 and 21. Clause 1. The electric formula and long title stand part of the bill. The Honorable Chief Minister may now move the motion for passing of the bill.
I move the motion for the passing.
Question is that the bill be passed. Those in favor may say ayes. Those against may say noes. The ayes have it. The Goa Good and Service Tax Amendment Bill 2020 is passed. I am requesting the members day after tomorrow. There is a Goa Legislative Forum Day. Everybody should attend for that function. As there is no business before the House, I now adjourn the House till Monday, the 3rd February 2020 at 11:30 a.m.